Revelation based on scriptures, inspiration based on definitions, elaboration based on inscriptions. On the basis of everything, simplification, scrutiny, everything has come into account by means of Adhyayana Anusandhana. Adhyayana is proper methodology of study. Anusandhana is proper research methodology. The third thing is Anushthana, proper practice. Fourth thing is Achara, the tools of eligibility by which we can get these things. So these things are the four pillars of learning which existed in our system. So Shastra is something which requires eligibility for a person's character, eligibility for a person's exercise and spiritual rights, then go into proper research methodology and proper studying methodology. Then sleeping and studying, walking and studying, sitting and studying, reciprocal studying, all of these things are not comfortably prescribed and prescribed in our Shastra. So a methodology of study, research, action, obedience and practice has been very much stipulated by our Shastra. This is the primary structure or the compound, the foundation on which our traditional system of learning or pedagogy, it is known as ontopedagogy or theopedagogy, on the basis of which our system has been laid upon. So everything is known as Shastra because that which creates a Shasana, Shasanati Shastra Vidyapu. It creates a Shasana. What is Shasana? Shasana means an order. Shasana means an inscription or an inviolable injunction. It is based on one. What is the origin? Number two, what are the components? Number three, what are the divisions? Fourth, what are the expansions? Fifth, what are the explanations? Sixth, what are the experiences? In understanding and all of these things, what are the things to be done and not to be done? Vidhi Nisheda. So everything is pretty much compositely studied in Sri Shastra. It is composite knowledge, it is perfect knowledge, it is elaborate knowledge, consummate knowledge, divine transcendental knowledge. And our system of knowledge is based on this blemishless foundation of the whole epistemological industry of the world. And I want to say, if there are innumerable sciences which are very great, being known to human beings, like a person is understanding about water, that becomes hydrology, oceanography, hydrostatistics, hydrodynamics, oceanography, various other things are there. Tidal studies, tsunami, and tectonic studies on earth, geodynamics, geostatistics, geography, geology, geophysics, geochemistry, geobiology, innumerable new dimensions are coming into society. So everything is different, but astronomy and astrology, there is a little different. If you want to know each and every part and parcel of the world, that becomes various other contributive disciplining sciences. But astronomy and astrology, both being the pair of the same dimension. There are two things. One is pinda, second is anda. And if you are concentrating on a microspecific unit of the cosmos, that is known as Janma Kundali. If you are concentrating on the macrospecific ether, that becomes Jagat Kundali. Janma Kundali and Jagat Kundali, both things are the dimensions of astronomy and astrology. So these two things are very much essential for, number one, if you are understanding about part and parcel of the world, this science is making you to understand the holistic structure. Number two, if you are understanding and analyzing about the effect and procedure of various other things in the world, this is giving you an idea of what will be going to happen tomorrow. A comet is going to meet our Earth in the year 2041 AD. Let it be as for designing a person's movement, it gives you four major studies of thought. One, what that is destined. Number two, what that is suggested. Number three, what you have to be prepared for. Fourth, how you have to modify yourself. These things I have no time to discuss all of this. Saturday I believe that there will be a different platform for discussing these four things. It is not only giving something which is very stable, which is very standard, which is very immutable, which is very rigid, but also flexibilities, modifications, self-study for preparation of things, whatever it may happen, everything is the component or the compound study of the astrology. So it is a holistic study, it is a specific study. It deals with a macro structure, it deals with the motion of the restrictive, prescribed, stipulative motion of a micro unit. So it is great because it deals with the micromost unit and the macromost cost. So it deals with both the extremities of an individual and its life and a wholesome individual structure which consists of thousands or uncountable species and spatial standards. That's why the science is to be greater, because of which, one, it should be given the highest record. Number two, it should be given the highest sensibility. Third, it should be having the highest rightness. Fourth thing, it should be read with the highest scrutiny. Fifth, it should be watched with the highest meticulous measures of observation of teaching, training, practice, and devotee, etc., which is not there level now. So these things are necessitating that it is a greater science. Now let us come to the Ayanamsa which we are going to take today. Everything is based on a calculation. You know that the mathematical progression or an arithmetic progression, AP they used to call, whenever there is a small slippery in any of the steps, the whole system will lead to a very wrong message. So the precision is very much to be stabilized. There are three types of problems. Wherever we are going very properly, at the end we are deviated. Like Antimo Paya Nishtha, we used to say in Vaishnava, it is Antima Apaya. The Madhya Apaya is, if a person is proceeding, in the course of proceeding, he will be misled somewhere else, due to which he will be mistaken something else for something else. This type of malapprehension and misleading will come. The first thing or the foremost thing is, Prathama Apaya or the Prarabha Apaya, in which the initial basic thing itself goes wrong. Ayanamsha is such a very critical and crucial issue where the fundamental of that Ayanamsha itself goes wrong, wherein by everything goes wrong Ayanamsha, like Panchanga Ganana, like Muhurta Nishchaya, Lagna Nishchaya, Kundali Nishchaya, Desha Buddhi Antara, everything goes wrong independently as well as holistically. So it lies in the Prarambha Paya, wherein by even the slightest deviation from the pathway of precision leads to various other problems. According to modern astronomy, according to our traditional astronomy, according to the traditional astronomy of the contemporary astral societies of various worlds, and also the multi-modern astronomical societies wherein they are attuned to our systems or differentiated from our system, we have to take a comparative view. Basically, there are two systems. One is based on the fixed stars, that is the Sthira, and the second is based on the vernal equinox. That which is based on the ecliptic longitude of the fixed stars, that is what we call sidereal, and that which is dealing with the ecliptic longitude of the basic thing, vernal equinox, which is not based on the fixed ones but on moving ones, that is known as tropical, which is known as the modern astronomical method. We belong to the sidereal school of thought, and modern astronomy, the Vedic astrology, belongs to the sidereal school of thought, and tropic zodiac is concerned very much in modern astronomy. So this Ayanamsha or the proportionate difference is calculated by the angular difference that exists between the ecliptic longitude of a sidereal in comparison or competitive study with that of the tropical equivalent. And it is also the angle by which the ecliptic longitude of the sidereal is lesser than the ecliptic longitude of the tropical area. This is the general astronomical definition for this thing. Then apart from these things, we have to also conclude our systems according to modern things. To be over technical, there are three views. One is totally to be absurd and orthodoxic, that is also wrong. Second thing, totally ultra-modern, that is also wrong. Wherever practical observations are non-contradictory, because knowledge is ever growing, knowledge is never being stamped or nailed at a particular period by a person. If something is, that is what we call Shruti Virodha Vihina, that which is not against the medulla oblongata of scriptures, we used to accept it as Shrauta. Even though it is not directly given by the Vedas, Shruti Pramanam, Sputeya Pramanam, Dharma Yukta Vachanam Pramanam, Yasya Pramanam, Nabhavet Pramanam, Kastasya Kuryar Vachanam Pramanam. It is the basis of the Vedas, and basic based inspirations have already told, elaborations on the basis. So there is a lineage. Whenever there is an observation which is not contradicting the Vedic scriptures, certainly we have to accept it. So we have to create a model in which it is neither ultra modern nor ultra-orthodox in nature, wherein by the practical growing observations of modern empirical scientific technology should be also taken into consideration. For example, recently there is a study on motion. It is known as proper motion of stars. You know that stars, they don't have any motion, that is what we feel, but they have silent motions. They have angular change of positions in the celestial sphere, and it is measured on arc second per year. 3600 arcs, they constitute 1 degree. So it is 60 into 60, it has been minimized in proportion. 60 into 60 is 3600. So it is a sub degree classification. 3600 arc is equal to 1 degree. And it is based not only on the planetary positions, but also on sun's motion and various other celestial positions and their internal angles. And it is based on the calculation of the radial velocity of the movement with the transverse velocity. And number two, how it can be calculated? It should be calculated with understanding the proper motion as well as understanding the angular position. The angular position of that particular planet or star in the celestial sphere, in its axis and orbit, that gives you the direction of movement. If something is moving, you have to calculate two things. One is, what is the motion magnitude with which it is moving? What is the direction towards which it is moving? So this type of understanding, the angular position of the planet, that gives you an idea which direction it is moving. Second thing, the particular proper motion system itself, that gives the idea what is the motion magnitude of the movement of all of these things. It deals with understanding of the right ascension and the declination of the planet as per the arc second per year. So it is to be very much calculated with the vector sum of all of its components in the celestial sphere, and it is an astronomical classification. Now apart from that, recently they have discovered that there is Barnett star. There is a star known as Barnett star. It is found to be moving, that is Ursa Major. It is moving 0.3 degree. It is moving. And then there are innumerable stars like Rho Chandrae and Gamma Galli. These are all few stars by which they have understood. Even some stars they have understood that they are moving towards the next approximate constellation. For example, one star has been identified which is moving towards the next constellation known as Definus, which may be reaching there by 2400 AD. This Gamma Galli star may be reaching the approximate constellation known as Definus. So stars moving, taking thousands of years to shift into constellation, formation of constellation, disintegration of constellation, fusion, integration, innumerable things will happen as per the proportionate study of this modern school of astronomy in proper motion. Apart from that, innumerable systems of identifying, protection. Those things have also been divided and divided by people. For example, now there is a system known as, the latest system is known as Leonard Merit Mass Evaluator. Ancient times we were using that blink comparator, which were very much forcibly used and to identify faint stars like red dwarf, etc. Red dwarf is a nearby star which is very fading in nature. So it cannot be watched. Now image differencing has come, in which even the faintest star, it can be well understood. This is the modern definition. And this type of ion answer, or this type of motion study, is not very new. Even the 400 AD, before 1600 years and more, there is a system of thought of Macrobius. It is known as school of Macrobius, school of astronomy. They have first identified that lot of stars are moving. Like we are having Edwin Halley, recent study of astronomical research, wherein he has understood that stars like Sirius, stars like Atmos, they have been moving half a degree away when compared to that of the exact position of 1850 years. So it is also being moving. So this type of ancient Macrobius to Edwin Halley of this thing, it has been continuously, there was a conflicting concerns among the Western as well as a group of people about understanding about the sidereal motion with the proper motion is also studied. So this type of understanding, now if you want to see the ancient school of system, they should see with their tapasya. There are two things. One is observation. Second thing is inner reservation. Inner reservation is by a cognitive drill. What is the name of the exercise? Cognitive drill. To consider Chaitanya as the consciousness as a divine presentation. Considering God as Jnanamaya or Jnana itself, the person doing an inner drill, he will get everything realized. And submitting the same with observations of eclipses, equinoxes, parallel, then various other transient positions and their impacts on the society in the form of daily, routine, disastrous movements that they experience in society with historical track records, as well as comparative track records in various provincial and productive sources, they have come into conclusion in observation that this will be so, this may be so, this may be this or that. So these things have arrived. Now we are having lack of software. There are two softwares, I think. There is one MOASTAR software in which I have observed in one planetarium. And second thing is HipRain software. Recent HipRain software that deals with the exact tracking of each and every odd second per year that can be very much vigilantly calculated. Understanding of their motion, constellation, mixing, fusion, diversion, everything can be calculated. This is the initial standard. Coming to our system, there are two systems. One is the cyclic system, second is the oscillatory system. What we call a trepidation. This trepidation system, wherein by we think that there is a 90 degree which is known as styria. We used to call there is a styria. The styria is known as a fixation, point of fixation, or point of sturdity which is 90 degrees. And taking the minimal composite astral power point as 0.3, they are getting 27 and having a zero unit, plus or minus 27 is the oscillation study or trepidation of our one system of ion answer. This is our system. So we believe that every 1800 years, it comes to a zero year or a zero constant, then it goes for minus 27, then it is brought back, then it is decreased and increased. This is known as cyclic. And this type of oscillatory system, what we call, he is not accepted by the scientific system at all. Even now, what we are having, that it is constantly, as per the modern science, it is this type of ion answer is constantly increasing. For example, if we are having now 22.64%, we may be reaching 27 by 2299. 0 year for us is 499 AD. That is the 0 year. Present position is 22.64, which is 24 lesser than the modern system of calculation. And after this 2299, it will reach 27 on that year and it will start decreasing. Whereas the modern calculation will start increasing. So there is a wider gap. There is an unbreachable cleavage between this modern and traditional schools of thought, where we have to come at a conclusion at all, which should have a worldwide recognition and worldwide debate, which may blossom in a small auditorium. So starting from this auditorium, it should spring, roar and echo into various corners of the world. This is the problem. And even there are supporters and antagonizers for this system that are to support Surya Siddhanta and our system of oscillatory trepidation. We have Theon, who belongs to the 4th century AD, who was the first most of the foremost astronomer who proclaimed the theory of Surya Siddhanta. That is equal to Surya Siddhanta, that it is oscillating. But what he has done is, he has taken that 27 degrees, what we are having as a standard, as a calculable standard base. It is a calculated, produced standard base. It is the phala, what we call as produce in English. It is the produce of us. It is a produced standard base of our calculation, 27. What he has done is, he has taken that as a base for evaluation, and taking that 27 for evaluation, he has made it to calculate with into plus, that is 0.3, which has resulted in 80. That is 81. Just as we are having 27 degrees, taking 90 degrees as constant or base and getting the produce of 27, he considered that 27 itself as a calculable base, by which he has made the same corporal minimal base of the astral situation, that is 0.3. He has calculated that 27, resulting in 81, in which, neglecting that one, making a composite figure, he considered plus or minus 8 degree is the oscillation angle of the oscillation orbit. Just as we are having 0, plus 27, minus 27, the trepidation calculated by Theon of the 4th century AD, which is also an oscillatory school of thought, is plus 8, 0, minus 8. Minus 8, 0, plus 8. That was his trepidation. And even in our own astronomers, we are having ancient scholars like Manjula, the first proponent of this type of thought of what we are now calling as the tropical ecliptic longitude, that was earlier proposed by the same astronomer of Manjula of our land, which was not accepted by the famous traditional Vedic astrologers, who are considered only with the sidereal ecliptic longitude classification. So these are all somewhat basic components which we are going to give about the Eastern and Western thought. Coming to the Western thought, first I want to go to Eastern. What are the advancements that they have made? Number one, what I want to say is, they have made a fiduciary study. What is it? It is known as a fiduciary, and it is made by Mose Eldenberg. Mose Eldenberg made a fiduciary study, wherein they say that the planetary positions in your ephemerides, constantly they are going on a slippery at the rate of 50.2546 degrees per year. So 50.2546 is the annual slippery constant, which may be more or less, it is happening, and this is known as fiduciary. And number two, by calculating the vertex, that is known as a vertex calculation, in which by concluding the vernal equinox standardization methods, we can arrive at the rate of precision very, very precisely. Number three, is a reverse type of evaluation. I've already told in pulse diagnosis. If you want to understand pulse diagnosis and interpret diseases, it will take 1,000 years. So take diseases and their well-registered or recorded medical reports and analyze them and produce congruities between them and create a tabulation. Based on that research, you create a software or some vibrator or some vibrant analysis software or some any other method by which the pulse diagnostic interpretation can be read and interpreted by a diagnostic tool rather than a person's diagnostic skill. Likewise, there was a very great scholar who is known as Alexander Moore. This is Alexander Moore, taking the horoscope of Adolf Hitler, 37 remarkable, indubitable incidents he has taken from his life, and comparing that with the tropical position of the planets and their latitudes, he has derived at the way of making the horoscope to understand the precision as well as precision by means of a reverse mechanism. So interpret the incidents and attune the horoscopic positions and tropical points as per the incidental position. So that's what he has made. And there are few tests made by few people to mention Lord Donald Bradley. He's a very famous astronomer. He has taken three special exercises. One is the synaptic vernal precision exercise. He has created a synaptic vernal point, a common point, which is shuffling in between, which takes more or less the average between the various shuffling points. Now we are having numerous points. There is the Babylonian Hinamsa is there, Raman method is there, Lahiri method is there, then K.P. Krishnamurti Padhati method is there. Then innumerable, the Galactic Research Institute, the Galactic Survey Institute, they have made one standard methods of observation of Hinamsa. More than 15-20 Hinamsas are there. So to conclude everything with more precision and to create a standardization for that, he created an average point by which the synaptic vernal point can be derived. He has made that, Donald Bradley. And the second thing is he has made a wonderful research on the system of the tropical logic or zodiac, not sidereal logic. What he has done is he has made a project known as Sun in the Lunar Mansion. What is the name of the project? Sun in the Lunar Mansion. So more than 2,492 clergy points and positioning in three different zodiacs with four lunar synthesization, he has derived at innumerable things, arriving at 99.8% of precision or predictability in the tropical standards, not sidereal ones. The third thing is very much interesting. It is known as Michael Gaivalian experiment, by which 12 set or data set of people, they have been selected. Schizophrenic, alcoholics, great thinkers, scientists, politicians, musicians, all of these various people of the society, 12 databases have been created. All Hinamsas are put into test. All Hinamsas are put into test, and how much it is suitability. There are two things, summability and hitability. How much it can be summed for identifying the person's nature. Number two, what is the hit point? How much the precision is there? Even if it is summed up, how much is the hit point? He got a very, very whimsical and random answer that some Hinamsas are suitable for scientists. For example, if Tarun Chopra Hinamsa system is there, it was suitable for musicians. But it is totally absurd and not working for scientists. Like that, he has derived exactly, he has made the database. Somebody should go through the database because that is practical and that is real. So everything was very much yesterday calculated by them, and he told that it is very impossible to fix the Hinamsas. For really interpreting the realistic structure of a person, mobility of person, which we see by perception. And there he has given four ideas, which is an idea for ourselves also. Number one, he has asked us to create more rating exercises. This is a system of rating which we have made. The only problem with astrologers or astronomers, the traditional astronomers, is three things. One, they are not interested in learning more. They are not interested in experimentation. Third thing, they are not interested in getting advice or suggestions from other people. They know that they have read enough, they have enough to distribute for others, and nothing to be verified. For everything they are saying, Tharan in Rupana. I am predicting for 20 years to people, everybody is saying that I am correct. Why I have to go for everything? Whether that is Kakatalia or not, whether that is accidental, or that the happening precision may be due to your own astrological beneficiary position, wherein by whatever you may blabber may come through. That is a story in which a person will be given an Adrishtangui Anguyeka. That is Adrishtangulika means that is a very fortunate ring. That Adrishtangulika, by wearing that, he will kick the king's crown, and immediately instead of being punished, there will be a serpent coming out of the crown, and he will be given more richness, and he will become very much intimate to the king, and he will lift the princess from a place for which he should be beheaded. But there will be a chandelier which will that will fall down to the particular place where she had been lying, and instead of he being beheaded, he will be more crowned, or he may be given the daughter in hand through marriage. So there are some stories, fictional and fabulous stories, which are giving information that a fortunate person, in spite of doing something perishable, is nourished and respected and worshipped and benefited. Even if a person is doing something good, we are experiencing, there may be a lot of such victims present in the audience themselves, doing something good because of lack of fortunate time or presence of abundant misfortune, they will be mistaken and put into trial. So this thing is very much common in the society. So if something is not learnt, something is not discussed or clarified, something if it is not experimented or verified, these three things, if it is working, that may be due to the horoscope of that person, so that he has escaped from your blabbering. Second thing, it may be your horoscope by which your blabbering are becoming scriptures and inscriptions. The third thing, it may be coincidental which may not work for longer years. So, this is the problem. We have to take into suggestion various other things, even Westerners. We have to take them into suggestion. Even if we are true, even if we are greater than, we have to prove it by experiment. So, what he told is number one, rating. You develop a lot of rating exercises by which we can arrive at precession, number one. And number two, you take the moon's correction to the parallax and work it with several horoscopes on several levels. Third thing is ascendant testing. Do it with Lagna and test it with various circumstantial conditions. That is, beholding with your prediction standard as per your personal experience or narration. Number three. Number fourth is very simple. He has told us to create a new compromisable system of ayanamsa which cannot come into the flaws. So these are the things that are undertaken by various other Western people. Considering our Eastern system, there are innumerable confusions. Lot of confusion. The first thing what the Westerners say is, you make the calculative system or the astro-calculus method of coming at the vernal equinox study or the tropical standard study, whatever it may be, to go for the calculation or prediction or exact estimation of your person's standard for 10 horoscopes being given to 10 persons in different parts of the world. You will get exactly the most precise and the same answer. You take a village, there are 10 astrologers. You give the same thing, same input to 10 astrologers who are following the same tradition, who are following the same paddhati, following the same lineage maybe even, give it to them, they will give you 10 horoscopes which are entirely different from each other. It may be proximate, it may be different, it may be distinct, it may be entirely incongruous. The angle of variation, if it is Rashi, it may be having a slighter differentiation. The differentiation will be more if it is in Navamsha. One night it will be even more. It will be having two or three houses later. Then it will be entirely different if it goes for Satyamsa, then for Nadyamsa. The more you go, the disparity is also, the cleavage is also wide, and that is the problem with those sciences. That is the number one. And number two thing, what we have to say is, recently there is a confusion with the Nadi system. Kakapujanda Nadi is there, then Vasishtha Nadi is there, Yoga Vasishtha Nadi is there, then Gautama Nadi is there, Vishwamitra Nadi. How far they are reliable, how far they are authentic, these things are not known. On the basis of this type of blind inscriptions, lot of people are following, totally closing their eyes to modernity. Not only modernity, revolutionary study of even our own traditional exercises as per the contemporary development. There are two things. It is not only modernity. Even in our own systems, there are permissibilities for revolutionary studies based on adhikara, eligibility of a person, kala, timing, pratesha, which is the area, the provincial network. So we are also having paricheda and vyapti. Thereby we are having our pervasiveness as well as limitations concerned with the person, place, timing and contextual exercises. That is not given to by these people at all. Third thing I want to know is, whenever you are taking a small unit, it is creating a vast cleavage in major systems. For example, transit of planets. 15th December, I still remember, 15th December 1990, at Tamil Nadu there was a very big debate. At that time, the Saturn, he was put into retrogression into Sagittarius. Then after everything, after the Makara Nivritti, he is entering on 15th December 1990 to Makara. As per one system, Trigan Vakyagrindha. And the Vakyagrindha system is say that Sun's entry into, that is Saturn's entry into the Makara happens on 10th February 1991 after 55 days. And it was celebrated at Tirunallar only on the day. 55 days later, if a particular transit is being celebrated or organized, all the people, all the children, those who are born, and all the destinations and all the other systematic evolution of whatever we want to do from understanding of time between these 55 days, that is put into obscurity, ambiguity and uncertainty. 55 days. And based on this, the 55 to 90, it differs, and for just medium rotatory devices or planets like Jupiter, it takes 15 days or something else. And for this normal planets which travel for 1 or 1.5 months, like Venus, like Sun, etc., it has 1 to 3 days. So this type of deviation, in hyper-rotary planets like Saturn, it takes for 50 to 90 days, 15 days for the mediocre, and for the inferior or small planets with the approximate distance in axis, they take for 1 to 3 days, but the deviation is uncompromisable. That is there in the system. The third thing is Desha Buddhi. How will you calculate the Desha Buddhi? If the Matru Garbha or Garbha Seksha is not properly calculated, that is your Desha Buddhi. So we have to go for only reverse mechanics. you have to study at least 1 lakh of Jatakas, yes, with special people. If you are taking your brother, brother-in-law, sister-in-law, who has no significance, it is not of use. And there is one more problem. There is a book known as Horoscopes of Famous People. They have given horoscopes for everybody. Even calculating the horoscope for the known people with a given time is difficult. They are giving a horoscope for Hitler, Mussolini, Napoleon. I don't know how they got the date of birth, exact time of birth. Even that may not be known to the mother herself. I don't know how they have got these things. So I have got a book. So there are two things. One thing, it should be a humble. Second thing, the person must be a very transcendental person, Rishi. Otherwise, how we can get lot of things, various other people, like Vasco da Gama, Marco Polo, everybody. Those who are there in the history, everybody's horoscope, Lagna Patrika is there. And marriage horoscope is also Sita Rama marriage, Radha Krishna's marriage horoscope, everything. Lot of the inventions are there. This type of inventions are very dangerous. Lot of dangerous inventions and innovations are there in the astro industry. How do you calculate this thing? Now, recently, somebody was talking about lot of new things. Like Vimshottari Dasha is there, 120 years Dasha is there. He is telling about something very different. That is 24, Chatur Vimshati, Chatur Vimshati, 36, 48, then Trisaptati, 72, then 82, then 105, 108, 116, 120. Innumerable things he has been saying, and he is saying that there are a lot of chakras. He has told 100 chakras, like Kala Chakra, Sira Chakra, Chara Chakra, Sandhya Chakra, Pancha Sandhya Chakra, Sudarshana Chakra, innumerable he is saying that. And innumerable like Vighatika Lagna, Prana Lagna, Mahaprana Lagna, Mula Prana Lagna, he is telling that it is being hidden in some scriptures. So this makes the idea to conclude, number one, as these things are appearing to be fallacious, whatever the ancestors they have told, they must be also fallacious. This may be a conclusion. Number two, if you are thinking this thing as hidden thing, there won't be any opportunity for you to go for the real hidden element in our Shastras. Number three, this type of deviation from the society makes the real astrology and its predictions and society is totally becoming inaccessible to the reality at all. So innumerable new things in our system are there. And apart from that, why this Panchanga or this Ayanamsha or the astronomy astrological system is being used? For few reasons. Number one, Muhurta, for auspicious dates and timings, which is based on performing of various things like Upakarma. And number two, it is for performing of our Pratas, then our Ishti, then our Pujana, not our daily rites are there. So it is there to deal with the Vrata, Ishti, Kratu, Pujana, Upakarma, performing our Samskaras, performing Utsavas of temples, and performing Samajika Utsavas or social festivals. So, not only our social festivals like Deepavali, Ugadi, you know that how Paral is being made. So, not only for this, but also those systems. For Devaraya Pagati, it is very much used. Apart from which, for Phalaganita, what is Phalaganita? To deal with the Vrishti, Kshama, Yuddha, Kalaha, Vriddhi, Krishi, Arthavriddhi, for everything, for prediction of economic development, for prediction of natural economic standard of the country, for prediction of wars and conflicts, for prediction of the general health, for prediction of any infectious diseases and pandemics, for prediction of agriculture, for prediction of productivity, national, gross level, composite, total level productivity, net productivity of the state, everything can be interpreted by means of understanding few things, like Sankramana, like Grahana, and various other calculations. They are very much useful for understanding these things. So, it cannot be performed unless we have a clear system at all. You know, twice there was a very great Vikrasadas which was celebrated at Srirangam once and also at Kanchipuram once. There was an astrological Vikrasadas. Even the recent year, the first day of the Shravana Masa, there was Upakarma. At the same time, there was the eclipse also. So, there was a comment between these two people, wherein by the Trikkalinga people, they told that as there is also the Sakramana along with the Grahana, there is Sakramana Dosha, so it should be shifted to Bhadrapada Purnima. And all the Drik Anuyayis or the practitioners, they practice only like that. And it is shown in Shastras that if you are having a dosha, if there is a possibility of dosha in the Vidita Kala, there can be Gunasiddhi in Avidita Kala also. If Shravana Purnima is the Vidita Kala, wherein you have been destined to do that, and if it can be defective, there can be some other period which is not being proposed or prescribed, which can be effective. So shift it to Bhadrapada, so that it is known as the Nikatopavati. The next opportunity or next option is to celebrate it in Bhadrapada Purnima. And the second system of thought, that is Vakya, they told that there is a system by which if the mid-noon happens at 45 night, if it is before the midnight, if it is before that midnight, that is 45 nadi, if the lunar eclipse occurs, then it may result with the particular sankramana dosa, are making that sankramana defective, by which you cannot perform that upakarma that day. As it is, apart from that 45, that is 47.41, whereas 54.23 is the sankramana kala, whereas after 47 nadi only, that is entering, that lunar eclipse is entering. As it is, after the midnight, which is 45 scale, that is the starting of the fourth quarter division of a day, then it is not a dosha, it is not effective at all. So we have to make the upakarma on the same day. And apart from the shastra, this type of astronomy, fixation of muhurtas are concerned with dharma shastra nyayas are also. That's why they are taking into nirnaya sindhu, dharma sindhu, and various other nibandha granthas for fixing the clash between the grahana tarpana as well as amavasya tarpana. And if it is mahalaya paksha tarpana, it is Paksha Tarpana or that particular Tarpana of Grahana or the Tarpana, Darsha Tarpana, which is, that is meant for that particular Amavasya, which is to be done. And it is based on Shastras, which say that there are Kala Nimitta Devatas, and based on their differences they have to be performed. For example, Tarpana is having a different time, and as well as this Grahana Tarpana is having a different time. And as well as the purpose is also entirely different. That is known as, this is known as Anuraga, this type of Grahana Tarpana is known as Anuraga, and that is known as Darsha. So as these things are, the components are entirely different, we can conduct it on different occasions. And somebody from the traditional school of thought, that Nityat Naimittikam Pradhanam. So considering Naimittikas have to be more specific and significant than that of the Nityas, as these type of things, Grahanas and other things are very much significant, we have to perform only that. So there is also a system of clash between these people. So the first area of problem is with astrology. Second area of problem is with astrology and astronomy. Third area of problem is with astronomy alone. Fourth area of problem is with astrology, astronomy and dharma shastra. So whenever we are having this Ayanamsha, Kala Nirnaya, Muhurta Nirnaya and practices, you have to take it into four divisions, wherein by mere astronomy clashes, astrology with astrology application that clashes, wherever that clashes with that of dharma shastras also, wherever that is having pure astrology, so we have to clarify where they are interrelated and where they are independent at all. And coming to our traditional system, I want to say something which may be understood by our people, but which is not understood by the whole world of astronomy, for which especially the Andhra Siddhantis, as well as our especially the Indian system of the traditional astronomy, should be given a special mark of honor and reverence for its human contribution and Herculean success in the process of reconciliation of these various apparent as well as imperent cleavages. According to the system, the basic system of Surya Siddhanta, which deals with some systems of representation, one is based on mere Ayanagati, and second is based on two major things. The third is based on correction. The major systems by which they are classified are, one is taking into the Karnataka school, second is on the Chayarka. The Chayarka and Karnataka are of two types. One is the specified or notified, and second is the adjusted or corrected. So it deals with the two things. One is the static, second is known as elastic. According to that, what we call as the Ayana Bhagana method mentioned by the Surya Siddhantakara, as it is totally contradictory to that of the system of observation now existing now. There is a system of observation of saying the precision model. It is known as rate of precision, which comes to 50.27. And it is totally against that observation, so that Ayana Bhagana is not fully reliable at all. The second system, whatever that is Trik Siddha, that can be modifiable, that can be adjustable, that can be attunable. The existing Chayakarna along with that of the Chayarka with the Karnataka, the available Karnataka, is not very much adjustable because of its non-drip in nature. It is not having that drip. So what we have to do is, we have to, it also, it is permissible in the Shastra, as Ayanabhadra, the first thing is ruled out because it clashes with the perceptible observation of 50.27 readings of the modern school of astronomical pattern perception. Second thing is, as the second system which we have been told about the Chaya and Karna, wherein why it is not attunable because of its static nature, it is also not reliable. The third thing is, whenever there is a possibility of adjustability of the Karnataka, taking into the zero value year. Zero value year is 499. And most of the people, even our Siddhantas, like Soma Siddhanta, Vajra Vasishtha Siddhanta, Brahma Siddhanta, everybody they have that standard of 499. And everybody, they are within that 499, 498. So there is a group between the 470 to 520. That is a common group within which everything can be made. Even great people like William Jones and Alan Leo and Max Kindle, even Western astronomers, they have some proximity, 499 or 498.1, 498.7. So they have some proximity of this year. So considering this as a standard, if it is adjusted towards the vernal equinox, there is a possibility of bringing a corrected Karnataka, and this difference between the corrected Karnataka with the Chaya Karnataka system of the uncorrected static system, that difference will give a Drip Ayanamsha, which is very much reconcilable to all other systems, and that is the standard view which has been made by our Siddhanti. The Siddhanti is of the famous Raja Mahendra Puri tradition. They have made this new thing to create a standard visualization of these things. There are innumerable Siddhantas have been introduced by people. 1925 there was a very famous Pune conference. They have given 13 resolutions for various Ayanamsas, and contributing that they have fixed, see, point of origination is very much Moolotpatti Nirnaya, a point of origination is very much required for 180 degrees. And there were two pakshas for that. One is the Raivat Paksha, second is the Raitra Paksha. It has been made by the Pune School of Astronomers only, like Ketkar. Dr. Ketkar, he initiated the process of Raivat Paksha first. That is, Revati is the Antima Nakshatra, the final constellation, and Chitra being the middlemost constellation, taking that as 180 degree standard, they have calculated everything to come with the vernal equinox. So that was being started. Then they had a problem to deal with the Revat Paksha. Number one, the problem is very simple. Everywhere, that particular degree oscillation or differentiation is between 23 and 24 through that particular period. And it is very low, that it is 1938. So it is very low, it is 4 degrees lower than the composite systematic understanding oscillation between the people between 23 and 24, it was very low. So the Raivat Paksha is totally against the common observation or even preferential observation of people coming into a very tight compound or boundary. It is out of boundary. So he has to retune it for Chaitra, which is known as reverse stitching or reverse tailoring. What is reverse tailoring? Or reverse stitching, stitching your feet as per the chapel is known as reverse tailoring. So he wanted to create a suitability for that 0499 AD, 0 year, and based on that he calculated with all stars and he has resulted in that star, what we call now Chaitra. And even in Chaitra there is no approximate fixation of that 180 degrees. It ranges from 179 to 180 degrees Celsius, and it is not also having the finite fixation or definite fixation with 180. Even he has taken the Chaitra, that proves to be wrong. So it is a reverse stitching or reverse tailoring system at all. So if you calculate this type of system, the basic, for example, if you take the 1980, 22, 12, 23, 41, and the corrected version of this Karnataka, that comes to 20 plus 14, 34. So these are the readings for the Ayanabhagana, readings for 1988, the Ayanamsha. Then the Chayarka and Karnataka method, the second method, it comes to 2341. And the third thing is 20 plus 14, 34, the corrected version. For example, the side real year, the total calculation system of the sidereal year, if you want to detect it and bring the variation method or differential variation for that, there is a calculating method used for calculating the sidereal year and its measurement, which is 365 years, then every 365 days for a year, which is calculated into Ghatika, Vighatika and Parama. And it is 15 Ghatika, then 31 Vighatika, and 30%. And if you have a corrected version that gives you 365 days, the same 50-50 vikatikas, vikatikas, and 23 vikatikas, and no param at all. So considering this 365, 15, 31, 30, and 365, 15, 23, and 0 for the sidereal year calculation in the forms of year, ghatika, vikatika, and param between the unadjusted chayarka and karnarka with the adjusted or corrected karnarka, that gives you the result of 324. In our minutes and seconds, it gives you 324, and whereas the differentiation is 830, that is 8 vikatikas and 30 param is the calculation difference. That is the difference. So this is known as the three dhyanamsa which these people they have derived. And in concluding this thing, I want to say some special factors of understanding of our astronomical science in comparison of the other things. You cannot read the same thing as if you are reading history, geography, English, continental, etc. It is not also like that as if you are reading the other sciences. It is not even like reading the Western astronomy. It requires a different system of thought. First of all, I want to say there are three vadas. One is the Pratantra Vada, second is Ubhay Siddhanta Vada, third is the Divya Vada. Pratantra Vada says, in our ancestral period, there were only limited exposure, there were only limited tools of vision, by which we know only things limited. So due to our limited vision, we have classified few things and we have differentiated. And technology has come for more precision and perfection. Infallibility is born with technology. So whatever our Shastras base they have, we have to take the base from our Shastras. No doubt we have to interrupt everything from the modernity. There is also a question. There are Vulcanus, Neutus, Aspetus, innumerable new trans-Neptunian planets they have named now. So there is also a question somebody asked in astrological seminar. One, why there are only 9 planets now recently they are introducing new planets at all? Innumerable planets are being introduced. Then I told you are not asking a second question. What is that? In our 9 planet system, Sun is not a planet, it is a star. And second, Moon is not a planet, it is a satellite. Why they are introducing the planet system? You are not answered. So both the things can be answered because our system of astrology or this systematic basis that deals with a different type of approach. Those elements are celestial bodies which are creating impact on the spatial and spatial synthesis, they have been taken into account. And you know, so many planets may be there. We used to believe that lot of andas and brahmandas, mahandas are there. But those who are taking place or participation in the predominant destination or determination of spatial life and exposure, they are counted. It deals with three things. One is Ananvaya. Second thing is Pratinidhya. Third thing is Vaishvika. What is Ananvaya? Those planets, those who are not considered with the system of task. For example, in an office, everybody will be there. There will be a peon, clerk and everybody. If there is a board meeting, the peon is also there in the particular office atmosphere, or a clerk is also there. Why he has not been introduced in the panel? How many will be asking like that? Because Ananvaya means, while calculating something, the other factors, even though they will be known to the people, they were not considered for that particular purpose. Second thing is Vaishvika. They are connected with some spatial activities which are not included in this trend or analysis. Third thing is Pratinidhya, wherein by a particular planet that takes the representation of its proximate planets and that leads and contributes the benefits or malefits. So these type of approaches are being done by our people. And in that context, Sun and Moon, even though being a star and satellite, as they are read as per their influence, not their presence and participation, their influence on calculation, evaluation and determination, they are also included because they are also the determinant factors. So this was the reason for the people. So there are also pre-Neptunian planetary system, Neptunian planetary system, and post or trans-Neptunary planetary system. Three systems are there in the society now. Our system is pre-Neptunian, wherein we don't include this Neptune, Uranus, Uranus, that is Pluto and everything. Second thing is Neptunian. Now most of the recent software, as well as some scientists, they have invented three planets more and they have introduced that. It is there, whether present or whether influential, that is to be discussed between us. Influential study is the ruling study in astronomy rather than study of near presence. So this is an influential study. So this is what we want to say, that there are some confusions in the course of modernity. Few things are to be observed, identified and included within us. few things are to be totally ruled out. So the Pratantravada, which deals with the understanding of technology, that it should have a semi-permeable osmotic filter, wherein by the observable things or permissible things can be observed or permitted, and so many things which will affect the standard foundation of the system, they are not to be considered at all. The second thing is Ubhaya Siddhanta Vada, which has been made in one declaration. For all of your calculation of horoscopes, everything, your peculiar and specific things, you practice Trikandha Panchanga, and all of other temple related and event related things you practice Vakya Panchanga. The Ubhaya Siddhanta Vada, which was declared in some congregations. The third thing is known as the Divya Vada, which is made by most of the people. If you take into account wherever the things, even in the Vedas, Surya, he spoke, then Chandra spoke, and Brahma Sutra, he has already quoted this, the same auditorium. I have quoted Abhimani Vyapadeshastu, Visheshanandaji Bhyam. We consider that each and every material object is pervaded by a celestial force. Each and every celestial force is governed by a conscious element. Each and every conscious element is qualitative. Each and every qualitative element is delegative. Each and every delegated element is instrumental. Each and every instrumental element is authoritative. And this authoritative element is what we call Devata. So there is Paramatma or Brahman. And he is like Vishasma, Svatapavate. Everybody is under his control. He is subjected to the divine order. Everybody is working. So we consider there is an element. Element is having a force. Force is having a nature. Nature is having a pre-designed program. That program has consciousness. That consciousness has a determinate figuration. That figuration or personification is having a form. That form is known as a celestial representation or delegation of God. That is what we call Devata. Even though this cannot speak, Russia and China cannot speak together. They cannot meet together. Russia and Australia, they cannot meet together countries. But Russian and Australian Prime Minister can sit like us, like this. In proximate thrones, they can be seated like Abhimanis, they can speak, and their own indeterministic nature of determination is different from your calculation. So Divya Vada says that you are calculating these things as celestial bodies with the tropism, extension, motion, retrogression, progression, aggression, collision, what are the astronomical impacts, you are calculating them as mere material bodies. So Divya Vada says that even if you look at either, you must come purely scientific, or you have to throw the treatises. Because the treatises, they say that even Surya Sudrata, if you start or if you see the Madhyama Adhikara, you can see that Surya himself has given initiation to Mayacharya. Surya has given the Upadesha to Mayacharya. Surya is a body, and there are innumerable Suryas, and they are just material compositions, and they have no conscience or sense at all. He is the Western school of thought. Surya is not only a body, but also a governing agent. And that agent is a celestial representation, and he has form, he has ability, he has compatibility, he has proper power to move with people, he can initiate, he can invigorate, he can bless, he can be propitiated by rituals, worship and penance. So aradhyaha, bhujyaha, upasyaha, everything is included in this. Either you have to prove it, believe it, or totally leave it. You must not confuse these things with other things. So it says that what is the day for Brahma, night for Brahma, what is the day for a Deva, night for a Deva, how strictly has been done. So our treatises, like Surya Siddhanta, or any other traditional treatises, like Soma Siddhanta, Brahma Siddhanta, I have told, innumerable commentators also, that everything has originated with a theosubstantial study. Study of deity, study of God, study of worship, study of inner revelation, study of other things at all. So this type of Vada, that like Divya Vada, it says that if you calculate that we are the celestial operation of the material bodies, then you can say that it is not moving, it is moving, or anything can say that. If you consider the celestial representation also, then you have additional inputs, you have special inputs, you have such inputs which are not reachable by your modern systems of calculation, whether it may be a neckline or a hipline software, you cannot understand everything. That is the Divya Vada, our school of thought. So, in this basis, you say Vakya Adrik, Kasya Vakyam, Kasya Adrik. There are innumerable things. Who says and what is their level of thought? Are they anywhere competent to either comment or to verify or to understand or to realize or to make other realize? Are we competent? We have to go for a self-evaluation or introspective study before that. That is why it is known as Veda. So Veda, I want to give the five meanings of Vedas here. One is, we think that pratyakshayanam mithyavayastu payam uddhate is a common definition known to all. That which reveals, that which is known through pratyaksha and anumana, perception and inference, is known as Veda. Number one. Number two, even in pratyaksha, whatever we are seeing, we may be having optical deception or intellectual deception. Even not only Vedas are known for apratyakshas, even on perceptible things or understanding the perceptible things in the Atatmya method, that is the system of understanding as it is, where it is, or as where is tradition, then for that you have to note the Vedas. So Vedas are not only the providers of knowledge for things which are not perceptible, that is imperceptible or unintelligible, even on intelligible subjections, for giving the clarity, essence, ascertainty and accuracy, you need Vedas. Number two. Number three, even if you can see things accurate and precise for understanding Dhali, how it will be in future, how its response and modifications will be there, for understanding that, you know, something Vedas are to do with, without which you cannot get the proper aid at all. And number four, apart from this thing, whatever you are seeing, even the being seeing things, they are having unseen elements or dimensions inside. Pratyakshasyapi apratyaksha bhava. Even the seen elements, they have unseen portions or divisions inside. To see them, they need that. And fifth, even though you are seeing this thing, Sangopanga Jnanasya, you are seeing only one proportion. It's comparative study, that's what I told in one seminar. In the Global Consciousness Project, they have given you a very wonderful statement. You cannot pluck your flower without disturbing a distant star. Somebody asked, what is the essence of your Global Consciousness Project? They told you cannot pluck your flower without disturbing a distant star. On the basis of this Global Consciousness, Sangopanga, if you are seeing a leaf, you are seeing only a leaf. But in connectivity with air, ether, consciousness, mind, this galaxy, other constellations, super galactic structures, there will be either an infinitesimal or considerable, conspicuous or latent, whatever it may be, there will be an internet connectivity. So to understand that, you need Veda. So Vedayati iti Vedaha. Not only apratyaksha vishayan Vedayati iti Vedaha, pratyaksha vishayanapi samyak Vedayati iti Vedaha. Vartamane vidyamananam padarthanam api bhavi rakshanadikam samyak vidhiyate anena vedayati iti vedaha. The fourth thing is sthula padarthanam api sukshmatvam anena vidhiyate iti vedaha. The fifth thing is sangopangena samyak asmabhihi avagamyate anena margena anena upayena iti vedaha. So vedayati vedaha iti vedaha means that is not only giving pratyaksha, not only giving apratyaksha, it gives the sukshma of the sthula, it gives the bhavi of the vartamana, it gives the sangopanga patana, sangopanga darshana of each and every smallest particle, minutest particle of the world. So it is an etheric or composite study of macro particles and the most microatomic structure of the macrocosmic ether. So that is why it is known as the Veda. These five things are the various other modifications or various other definite modifications of the term Vedayati iti Vedaha. So something to be considered, that Vedas are meant only for the next world, meant only for liberation, meant only for something which is not perceptible to sensor, that is absurd. Veda gets the Nayakatva or Pradhanya, or it gets the predominance, whereby it is going to interpret about something unintelligible. But even on intelligible, perceivable things, to create the clarity, to create about the futuristic expansion, to create about its subtlest expansion, to create about its multifaceted and multidimensional expansion and contact to studies. For all of these things, apart from imperceptibility, Vedas are meant for five readings, so they are very much essential. And the concluding statement is, we have to possess a system, which I lamented in the previous auditorium lecture also, the same stage, in a different auditorium it may be. I have given that also. We must have something like the Sikshana, Prasikshana, Vikshana, Samikshana and Parikshana, these things are to be essential. Sikshana is, we must be having thorough knowledge in scriptures. Most of the astronomers and astrologers, they don't have thorough knowledge in scriptures at all. And interpretation, contemporary interpretation, evaluative interpretation, comparing interpretation with the modern developments, etc. So these things are very much essential. So that is number one, that Sikshana is not that. Second thing is Prasikshana, intensive training in astronomical practices. There are only two options, taking outer tools or inner tools. If you are taking outer tools, you have to design a lab. If you are taking the inner tools, then you must sit quietly and in a placid mode, in an inert mode, in a mood of self-tranquility and self-embedded space wherein you can realize the reflective, transparent surprise of your own inner wonders or inner splendors of your realistic inherent etheric space, Chidakasha, you can realize within yourself. So that is very much essential. So Shikshana is proper education. There must be from some other institute, there must be BSc Vedic Astronomy. It cannot be very much affiliated to the modern trend. You know that most of the people are anti-scientific, anti-theistic, anti-Brahmanic, anti-Sanskritic, and innumerable such words you can find for these people. So unless you create a Nobel Prize, unless you create a very great prize like a Templeton Award for knowledge realization through spiritual means, unless you create a global awareness, by doing something visibly, unless somebody from this school of thought emerges as a global torchbearer to the evolving and growing system of modern technical astronomy, somebody unless represents our system and creates an eye-opening session, it is not possible for a global acceptance or universal acceptance. For that, a different system should be established. It should have BSc, MSc, that is in astronomy, that is Shikshana. Second thing is Prasikshana, Prasikshana. Prasikshana deals with Nityaradhana, the Nainitika Aradhana, Upasana and various other things that must be done to people without meditation and other exercises. You cannot realize these things. You have to take the shelter of modern tools then. Then there is no use for our traditional culture and traditional lineage at all, that is Prasikshana. And third thing is, the society should watch. There must be a watching group what they are doing and how to cull out the other evil practitioners or fake practitioners. That should be some sort of sadhikshana that should be in the society. And that should be some system by which a person can get into the divine blessing. Dikshana is what we call here the anugraha of Acharya and Bhagavan. So unless a person, yamaivesha vipirunate tena labhyaha, tasyaishatma vipirunate tanu swam. Yetat sarvam janardana, so says the Vishnu Sahasranamadhyaya. So unless, as it is revealed to Brahma and various other people out of divine mercy or shower of divine affliction, there should be also a possibility to get the divine sanction, to get the spotless immaculate knowledge which is universally applicable, reliable, acceptable, adorable and relevant. For getting that knowledge, you have to go to the purpose. So, number one, to create a proper system of education. Number two, to create proper training. Number three, to have a proper watchdog methodology to see if the things are happening in the society, and also to curb out the unruly elements inside the society so that the genuinity and credibility, accountability of the system can be established inside. Number four, to create a common forum to take into intellectual, financial and executive resources for that. Number five, to eternally try for all of these things so that the fifth thing, that is the shower of God, will be God by which we can get the real inner realization. By that of this inner real realization, that is revelation, I think that we can get more opportunities to show, apart from our stage speeches, apart from our scriptures, apart from our writing, and apart from the discussions that are taking between only hand clappers and head nodders. It should go to the rational society, it could go to the scientific society, skeptic society. It should be given some sort of vimochana or emancipation from hand clappers and head nodders. It should reach the antagonist in the society, and once more our system and the status should be well preserved, well nourished. Once again, the dawn of the Bharatiya Vidya, our Arsha Parampara, should be reinstalled. The continuous, the tiring, sparing, no effort activities that are done by ISER is very much applauded. I wish, pray, and bless the institution and the leaders to get more vigor, color, grammar, and all other essentialities that should enrich and enable and empower them to do more in the society, creating wide awareness and wide reach in the society to establish mass awareness and mega transformation within the soonest decade possible. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.